Hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Age 2. Last we left off, Orsino decided to turn himself into a fucking harvester, despite the fact that we had completely decimated the Templars in like 5 seconds. And as a side note, I just noticed this. Even though she was clearly shown ripping the head off of the harvester there, it's back! Huh. Great! Fine! Whatever! Moving on. To loot the Templars we killed before. There's a very good chance that this video may in fact be the last one. We'll have to see how that goes, of course.
That's enough!
Yeah. Okay. Yep. And a range demon. Goody. Ah. Jeez. You both had to grab me, huh? Is that what you're saying? Okay. Well, enjoy that. There you go. We're very close to the end of the game now, guys. We can't go that way at all. We can only go this way. Whoa, a bunch of dead demons? A pride demon? And abominations? And Sandal? Oh god.
Enchantment?
Oh. Yeah, come to think. And I ended up not making crap. Wait. Because I did kind of forget to do this before. Sandal's store, but I didn't make any runes, damn it. Curses! I did not think this one through. I guess I'll just have to enchant what I've got. Or chant with what I've got. I think I'm good on the health portion front. I can always use more injury kits. And sell out the junk. But we should probably have things, Wait a minute, I can't... Oh, okay. Is there anything I can actually enchant on this? Room of Protection. Okay. Back. But let's see. Seeker of the Grey. Bianca. Let's see. Primeval that increases attack speed. That works. So he ends up getting that lyrium, but now that it's useless. Or not harmless, anyway. Let's see. Let's keep it to the ones that we've actually got. Rune of Striking. Rune of Impact. Chance to knock an enemy back. Huh. Alright. That works. Heartbreaker and Backstabber. She is with us after all. And Backstabber. Kind of surprised I have no slots on my staff. Well, that's gonna have to do it, isn't it? Oh, yeah, and you can add them to the slots of your companion members. That's what all of those extra little upgrades are over the course of the game.
Enchantment?
Yeah. Yeah. Something like that. And Orsino's signet ring. Not terribly useful to me at the moment. Okay. So, Sandal is once again eerily in the right spot at the right time, having killed a whole bunch of monsters and demons. Of course, because, you know, that makes sense. What's in here? Oh, a whole bunch of Templars. Great! Terrible job of quelling the magic, Templar Lieutenant. More rogues. Damn it. Okay. You guys are so keen on trying to take us on.
I found this amazing hat shop in Lowtown.
This is not the time, Izzy. It really isn't. Okay, so. There's still that other door. What's in here? Oh, shit. Well, you know, that went well. And what's in here? Oh, praying circle of mages and Templars alike? Of course they're praying to a demon. What else would they be doing? Damn it. They really, really, really tried to paint it that there was some sort of equality between them, but I'm sorry, I don't think the Templars had any right to go as far as they do. Alrighty, so came through here. Out into the Templar Hall. No, we can't go that way. And we can't go through that door because there's a fire there. Oh look, more Templars! And while we're at it, grab one of these. I'm sure that felt good.
I'm getting overwhelmed.
Are you? Getting overwhelmed, you say? What's no, no. Just like randomly grabbing stuff off of people. But we're not done here. No. See, there's still this door here. Oh, great. Fantastic. Okay.
It's too much!
Damn it. Wait, wait, before you trip it. Alright, so what's in these rooms? Izzy!
It's done.
It's done. Izzy again, if you wouldn't mind. Templar ceremonial cummerbund, huh?
Such a slave driver.
Is that so? Marcino and Meredith's room. Fuck the lot of them at this rate, I swear. Dragonhide Mantle of the Predator? Oh yeah, this is technically a... This is a, warrior armor. Interesting. But I'm gonna stick with the champion armor. Oh. Izzy.
Happy now?
Kind of. So, what's in here? Oh shit, that was loud. Okay. Oh shit. Gonna charge. Maybe I can disrupt his spell casting there. Oh shit.
Get back!
There we go. And it's one of them's already dead. Doesn't solve anything? Sure it does. It solves people trying to kill me, no longer having the ability to kill me. Shield of the Resolute. Something that you could give Aveline this late if you felt like taking away the special Shield of the Knight herself that you gave her your soul. But, yeah. So, I think we're in the Gallows Courtyard.
And here we are, champion. At long last.
You're a monster.
You'll pay for what you've done here.
I will be rewarded for what I've done here. In this world and the next. I have done nothing but perform my duty. What happens to you now is your own doing. You were never part of this circle, and I tolerated that. But in defending them, you've chosen to share their fate.
Knight Commander, I thought we intended to arrest the champion.
You will do as I command, Cullen.
No. I defended you when Thrask started whispering you were mad, but this is too far.
I will not allow insubordination.
Whoa!
We must stay true to our path. You recognize it, do you not? Your lyrium, taken from the deep roads. The dwarf charged a great deal for his prize.
The idol? You made it into a sword? Have you been carrying it around with you this whole time? It killed him, Meredith.
The idol poisoned Bartran's mind in the end.
He was weak, whereas I am not.
You're not.
All of you, I want her dead!
Enough! This is not what the order stands for. Knight Commander, step down. I relieve you of your command.
My own knight captain falls prey to the influence of blood magic.
Way to go, Cullen!
You all have. You're all weak. Allowing the mages to control your minds, to turn you against me.
No, Meredith.
But I don't need any of you.
Meredith?
I will protect this city myself.
You'll have to go through me.
Ooh. Idiot boy. Just like all the others.
She's clearly lost her mind.
Are those who stand before the corrupt and the wicked. and do not falter!
And also as a side note, ooh, you have Kellen in here already helping you. If you had let Carver join the Templars, he would also be standing with Cullen. He would say, and me, you know, and how everything is. And I'm deliberately not using all of my strength here. She took an arrow to the knee.
Maker, your servant begs you for the strength to defeat this evil.
Whoa. Whoa. Holy shit! And there's Varric charging in! She can animate those things? Oh, shit! That does not bode well! Why can't I not attack it yet? Okay. Gate guardian.
I'm coming. Hang on.
You're coming? There it is. You know, I'm not gonna help. I want to prolong this as much as possible. What? Oh, crap. And Aveline! And as a side note, a lot of the allies that you gain over the course of the game, like, say, Nathaniel or Zevran, they will often pop up here, too. Now, it may seem a bit anticlimactic for me to, well, hold off a bit. Oh my god, she's gonna do all of them! Come on, guys, let's focus on these things. Izzy, leave her be. Go after the statues. And there are more coming. Damn it. Again, I'm trying to prolong this because I want to see if I can get more of the allies to show up. A number of reasons. And Fenris? What? Okay. Stop going after Meredith. Go over there. I don't care. Meredith! Stop making it easier for them. I don't want her to die. Not this soon. That's better. Oh. Jeez. Wow. And hey, there's Zevran! He's joined the fray! Has there been any other guests that have added since I started this? Not yet. But yay on Severin showing up! Wow. Guys. Again.
Insult added to injury. Spare the mages. Give them freedom, and they would use it to tear down everything we hold dear. No, it cannot be allowed. I will stop it. Do you hear me, champion? I will defeat you.
Will you? No! Damn it.
I will not be defeated!
Meredith?
Make her hate your humble servant!
Oh god! This scene can go one of two ways. If you sided with the Templars, they will be deferential to you. But as we did not... Cullen, don't. They're gonna let us pass. Thank you, Cullen.
Word of the slaughter spread quickly. The champion's name became a rallying cry, a reminder that the mighty Templars could be defied. She had defended the mages against a brutal injustice, and many lived to tell the tale. The circles rose up and set the world on fire. More Templars arrived at Kirkwall to restore order, but... we were already long gone. We vanished into the hills, and circumstance eventually forced us all to leave the champion's side. Well, all of us except for Anders. You still hear the stories, of course. With each telling they grow, even if at the core remains the truth. A new legend had been so that's it. That's the whole story.
Then Meredith provoked the circle. She was to blame.
Or that damned idol was. Or Anders. Take your pick.
Even so, had the champion not been there...
it might never have even gone that far.
Key line, that.
I see.
So how is hearing all this going to help? You've already lost all the circles. In fact, haven't the Templars rebelled as well? I thought you decided to abandon the Chantry to hunt the mages.
Not all of us desire war, Varric. Please, if you know where the champion is, you must tell me. She is a hero. A woman that the mages would listen to. Someone who was there at the beginning. The champion could stop this madness before it's too late. She may be the only one who can.
Is that what this is all about? In that case, I wish I could help you.
Just tell me one thing, then. Is the champion dead?
though I doubt that.
Then you are free to go, Varric. May the Maker watch over you during the dark times ahead of us.
Same to you, Seeker. Same to you.
That was at Hawk's estate?
So, did you...
Gone. Just like the Warden.
What?
That is no coincidence.
Liliana.
So, do we proceed with the original plan, or keep looking?
It is in the Maker's hands now. We put our faith in him.
Charlotte's gone too? And the Seekers are looking for both of them. Wow. Just... wow. So... that's it. That's the end of Dragon Age 2. The last of the Dragon Age content to be released at this time. I mean, I know there'll be more in the future, and they're already working on Dragon Age 3 and some other DLC, probably an expansion, all of which I'll totally be all over when it's out, but for now, it's over. And you know, I feel kinda wistful. I mean, this journey started back 2 years ago when I first set out to record Dragon Age Origins, eager to share this game that I had just fallen in love with. These games are absolutely amazing. I love both Origins and DA2, each for very different reasons. I feel like there really has been an adventure, a journey I've traveled from humble recruitment into the Grey Wardens way back in Origins, to the instigation of the collapse of the Chantry, and a grand-scale war. DAO introduced the world, and hinted at something larger. While much of it is a fairly standard fantasy fare, questing against a greater evil that also happens to be a dragon, the writing, the unique spin on the RPG tropes, and the sheer depth of character development makes it so much more. DA2 has been the subject of controversy, especially among the fans. Many people were disappointed in the quality of the game, particularly because it was rushed, especially in the last act. The reused maps and the lack of free-range exploration, limited companion interaction, as in you couldn't just chat with them anywhere, you had to actually meet them in their home bases, so to speak. And the purported lack of overarching story turned a lot of people off from the game. The thing is, I agree it was released too soon. The third act jumped too quickly, and while the foreshadowing for Meredith's collapse was there, we never got to know her enough to see how bad she really got. There was a lot more that could have been fleshed out, and more development time would have really polished the game up to be really awesome. Cause here's the other part of this. DA2 has a very solid base. The writing is spot on, the characters are even more evolving than the last game. Their personal quests really added a lot to both the companions and the overall game. And I think that the larger scale implications for the future of the series are sewn brilliantly into the story of Hawk and Kirkwall. I think this is where the fans get really divided. Hawk's story isn't that of some intrepid, impassive icon of heroism, but of a humble refugee in a strange land, struggling to get by and finding themselves in the right place at the right time for events to unfold on them. Many players want the icon, but me? I'm a lot more attached to Hawk's struggle, for all they lose on the way to the top, and the ultimate loss for Kirkwall. That's just it. It comes down to personal taste, but Hawk's story is a lot more deep and meaningful because, unlike the hero who gets to decide everything, Hawk ends up having the world change them. It's a lot more realistic, I think, that Hawk has so little control and yet still gets saddled with the responsibility when things go wrong. And go wrong they do. In the end, what Anders does isn't well loved by the majority of players, who see it as a huge betrayal of their trust. And it is. But I can't fault him for being frustrated at seeing violence, isolation, mutilation, and barbaric practices, rape and tranquiling, implemented against his people, and no one even caring about their slow genocide. Blowing up the Chantry was unconscionable, but I feel it was necessary to spark a change that Thedas sorely needs. And I don't feel bad about the Chantry, the religion, not the building, falling apart by the time Cassandra is interrogating Varric. I believe Anders did the right thing. I expect a lot of you will disagree. Either way, this has been a long journey, and viewers, I am blessed and honored to have shared it with you. 2 years ago, I would never have believed so many people would take an interest in my ramblings. I can't express my gratitude or appreciation enough for watching, commenting, subscribing, joining me in streams, and for being legitimately awesome people. I can only hope that as I move forward, you'll continue with me, that I can continue to entertain you in the years to come. Thank you all so much for watching. And of course, feel free to add your own comments on the game here, but bear in mind, I do like this game. I know that I've said some things that may spark some debate, but I do like this game, and if you trash it, I'm not going to be terribly happy about that. Still, at any rate, again, thank you guys for watching, and I hope that you have enjoyed this Let's Play. I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to be doing next, but you'll see. I'll have to make that decision probably pretty soon, huh? I've got some stuff lined up, but at any rate. Thanks for watching. Through Origins, through Awakening, through all of the different DLC, through Dragon Age 2, Legacy, Mark of the Assassin, and hopefully whatever will come in the future. Hope to see you then. Which you can also look up, I believe, on the Dragon Age wiki. They'll let you know who voiced each of the characters.